approximately 390 million years ago, during the era nicknamed the Age of Fishes, what is now North Carolina was surrounded by vast oceans to the north and south. It was during this geologic period, called the Devonian, that a large mountain building event was ongoing. Due to the offshore collision of two tectonic plates, large volumes of magma intruded into the crust, creating truly massive monoliths of molten rock. These monoliths would go on to create thick masses of granite, which today remain in numerous exposed plutons such as Looking Glass Rock, Whiteside Mountain, and Stone Mountain. However, these bodies of magma were associated with something far more spectacular and unusual. Unknown to many, North Carolina is the only lower 48 state to produce numerous gem-grade emeralds. These emeralds have been largely found around the town of Hiddenite, such as the piece I am holding, which was collected there. Alongside other valuable gemstones, they formed in a highly valuable type of rock called a pegmatite, which are related to the masses of granitic rock that were formed in the same period. Just like them, they formed between 380 and 390 million years ago. During the early to middle Devonian period, North Carolina was part of a larger continent called Euramerica. To the southeast was a vast ocean and an ongoing plate collision where one tectonic plate was subducting underneath the Euramerican plate. The melted material from this collision then migrated upwards, creating a series of granite to granodiorite composition monoliths called plutons. While hundreds of ancient plutons can be found around the state, a similar process brought a cluster of them to the surface. After solidifying, the softer rock overlying the granitic rock eroded away due to long-term weathering. Sections of the granite also eroded, but because it was more resistant to erosion, it largely remained. In the case of rounded monoliths such as Stone Mountain, a type of erosion called exfoliation occurred. Just like concrete in the hot sun, this mass of rock expanded and contracted due to temperature variations. These variations eventually led to the creation of numerous cracks throughout the top of its edifice. Eventually, a large circular region of rock would become unstable, causing it to cleave off and fall to the ground. This process repeated many times for millions of years, leading to the creation of much of its rounded appearance. Due to the nature of the numerous silica-rich plutons, some of which covered as much as 25 square miles at depth, numerous pegmatites with large crystals were created. As a whole, pegmatites are one of the last parts of a large magma chamber to cool. They frequently form on the upper margins of a large magma chamber through a series of dikes. These dikes contain high amounts of water and volatile contents which favor the growth of unusually large crystals, typically averaging at least 1 centimeter or 0.4 inches in length. The longer a body of magma takes to cool, the larger the crystals it generates become. For example, this mass of quartz was formed underground, but not in a pegmatite, as it contains no visible distinct crystals and thus cooled relatively quickly. On the other hand, this piece of quartz has a visible crystal structure, indicating that it took a longer time to cool than the prior specimen. And this massive crystal, of course, did form in a pegmatite, taking on the order of many months to thousands of years. In the case of the area surrounding the town of Hiddenite, these pegmatites were unusually enriched in the elements chromium, vanadium, and iron. Thus, their inclusion in dikes of material changed what would have been a yellow-white beryl into a beautiful green emerald. Emerald is simply a type of beryl which is green, much like aquamarine is a type of beryl which is blue. Today, emeralds can be mined for a fee at several locations around the town, and gem-grade crystals can be found. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Adam Gatewood, for supporting this channel.